Hello, my dear students. Today we will take that the another part of the lesson, tissues. Tissue. If we talk about the definition of the tissue, we already give you the introduction and the types of plant tissues. We have to take the first plant tissue, that is meristematic tissue. Meristematic tissue. What are the characters of the meristematic tissue? First, what is the tissue? You might have defined it, or you might know that these are the group of cells similar in structure, perform similar function, and have common origin. That means the different types of cells is a group of cells having similar structure, perform similar function, and have common origin. That means they are derived from the same type of cell or cells. What is a meristematic tissue? Actually, it is a plant tissue, meristematic tissue. And what are the characters of the meristematic tissue? Number one is they are living cells. These are living cells. These are the characteristics. These are living cells. They are having prominent nucleus. That means nucleus is large. Prominent means large nucleus. Dense cytoplasm present in the cell is very dense. That means a lot of cytoplasm is present there. Cell wall is thin. They do not have thick cell wall. They have thin cell wall. Cell wall is very thin, so that they can divide more easily. These cells do not have vacuoles, or you can say central vacuole. These are the characteristic features of the meristematic cells. They do not have vacuole. As you already know, the difference between plants and animals, large central cell vacuole, it is a characteristic feature of plant cells. But this type of plant cell, meristematic tissue, does not have the central vacuole, so that they can be easily divided to produce new types of cells. Next, they are capable of division. They are capable of division. That means they divide continuously to for the growth of the plants. They are responsible for the growth of the plants. They are responsible for growth of the plant. These are the characteristic features of the meristematic tissue. And on the basis of their location, that means where they are present in the plants, on the basis of location, the meristematic tissue can be of three types. Number one, these are of three. The meristematic tissue can be of three types. These tissues, on the basis of their location, that means where they are present in the plants, they are of three types. Number one is apical meristem. नंबर सेकंड इज इंटरकैलरी मेरिस्टम एंड नंबर थर्ड इज लेटरल मेरिस्टम नंबर थर्ड इज लेटरल मेरिस्टम एपिकल मेरिस्टम इज प्रेजेंट ऑन द टिप्स ऑफ ग्रोइंग टिप्स आइदर रूट टिप और शूट टिप That means these the meristem which is present at the tips of the plant, either it may be root tip or shoot tip, that meristem is known as apical meristem, and they provide the primary growth means increase in height of the plant. That means apical meristem, they are responsible to increase the height of the plant. That is known as responsible for primary growth of the plant, apical meristem. Next is intercalary meristem is present at the base of leaf, leaf base and internode. That means that they increase the internodal length. Internodal length means if you have seen a plant like bamboo, these intercalary meristem, they are present at the this is node, it is also node, and this is internode at the base of the internode. That means here it is present, intercalary meristem, and at the leaves. Lateral meristem is present at the sides in trees, or you can say those trees which increase in their height, they are responsible for growth in girth. That is known as secondary growth. That means if I will cut this plant here, the lateral meristem will be present. It is lateral meristem. It is intercalary meristem. And if I will draw the tip of the plant here and root tip, it is apical meristem. Thank you. Have a nice day.